My state had consultants working on the new effort to see just what to do to make the troubled MetroLink system safer. The final comprehensive report was unveiled Tuesday afternoon and presented to a committee of the Bi-State Board of Commissioners. It's taken about a year to get to this point. Phase one of the study cost taxpayers $400,000 and made 99 recommendations. Then you paid another $500,000 to figure out the best way to implement the phase one recommendations, a total of $900,000. I talked to Bi-State President and CEO Talby Roach.
Was this worth our $900,000?
Absolutely. So sometimes, look, this is a very difficult problem that we need to take a very detailed look at. And we've done that. We've taken in different considerations and different theories, and we've also looked at things across the country.
Bi-State Commissioner Derek Keith Cox from Madison County, not so sure. He doesn't think the Board of Commissioners had enough oversight and thinks a lot of decision-making was left with staff.
Was this security studies, the two studies, was that worth our $900,000?
No, not so far, because it hasn't even come to the board to really dive in and to discuss and to actually have a vote. So we just spent a lot of money. I guess it makes us feel good.
Some of the main points of the new plan include better coordination among the three police agencies guarding MetroLink. That's St. Louis City, St. Louis County, and St. Clair County. Better customer engagement by security guards. Clearer roles between police and security guards so that the guards don't go too far. Access controls to limit access to MetroLink stations at 8th and Pine, Convention Center, Delmar, Forest Park, and Laclede's Landing. One major change is the plan to take firearms from security guards. Only police officers will be armed. Before, Bi-State had 140 security guards on the system. They'll no longer be armed, but the agency is only getting about 15 new police officers on the system for now.
But you had more than 100 guards with guns, but you're not having that many new police officers on the system. Seems like you're losing armed security personnel, not gaining more.
So in net trained new security personnel, in, for instance, police, full police officers who have the training and capabilities with the secondary, we're actually going to see increases in presence on the system.
What don't you like about disarming security?
Because I think it makes things less safe. I think the more trained people, good guys with a firearm, the better.
Toby Roach says he's confident the new changes will make a big difference in making the system safer. On Wednesday, elected leaders and police chiefs are expected to sign off on the plan at a public event, part of an effort to get everyone on the same page. I'll, of course, stay up on this deal after all. You paid for it.